Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are gonna learn how to crochet this fillet stitch. It's not just a simple fillet stitch, as you can see. We're gonna be playing a little bit with the squares. I think this design is perfect for the transition from summer to fall. You can create any garments or any accessories using this stitch, and it's not as plain as only double crochets or as only the fillet, the regular fillet stitch. Here you're gonna play with a row of double crochets, then some openings, then double crochets, then random openings. I hope you're gonna like it. So for the yarn, I'm using any number 3 medium yarn, or number 4 I think is medium yarn, nameless, brandless, and a 5.5 millimeter hook. I think you can use pretty much any yarn to create this design. I think the super extra bulky will not make sense to use it with this one, but I think from the thinnest to the, you know, maybe bulky, that will work as well. You can try to make a swatch just like mine and see how your yarn works out with this design. All right, if you are ready, grab your yarn, crochet hook, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. Let's get to work. And this is our first row, just double crochets. Turn the work and chain 4. The chain 3 will count as a double crochet plus chain 1. Skip the next, double crochet into the next. Again, chain 1. Skip 1, double crochet into the next. Chain 1, skip 1, or next, double crochet into the next. There is your openings all the way till the end. When you are at the end, chain 1, skip 1, or next, and put a double crochet into the third chain from the beginning. There is row number 2. Turn the work. Now we're gonna put double crochets in each stitch and chain. So chain 3 counts as a double crochet. Double crochet into the chain 1 space. Double crochet into the double crochet, into the next stitch. Again, double crochet into the next chain 1 space. Double crochet into the double crochet. All the way till the end. When you get to the last square, you will put a double crochet into the space, into the chain 1 space, and the last double crochet will go into the third chain from the beginning. 1, 2, 3. This is what we have so far. We'll turn the work again. Chain 3 counts as a double crochet. A double crochet into the next, a double crochet into the next. So we have 3 double crochets, to, one after another in a row. Chain 1, skip the next, double crochet, 3 double crochets, in next, 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. Alright, let me just show you and you will understand. Like so. So we'll have 3, chain 1, skip 1, 3, chain 1, skip the next, and put double crochet into the next, and into the next, and into the next. And you will have alternating a group of 3 double crochets, a opening, 3 double crochets, an opening, and so on till the end. And at the end, you are gonna have your 3 double crochets. The last one will go into the third chain from the beginning. Like so. So you don't just have a row full, a row openings, a row full, and then you're playing something different. And now we're gonna turn the work. This time we're gonna put, and I apologize for all the background noises. This time we're gonna put a row of full double crochets in each stitch and chain around. So chain 3 counts as a double crochet, and you will put 2 double crochets, one in each of the next. Then a double crochet into the space, into the chain 1. Then again, double crochets in one double crochet in each of the next 3. Then again into the space, and so on till the very end. And when you get to the end, again, you'll put the last one into the third chain from the beginning. So this is what we're going to be working with. And now everything starts. Actually, with this row, the repeat of the row starts. So we're going to do this one now, the repeat of the second row. We'll chain 4. The chain 3 counts as a double crochet plus chain 1. Skip the next double crochet into the next, chain 1, skip the next double crochet into the next, and so on till the end of this row. The last one goes into the third chain from the beginning. That's what we have. We're turning again. This time it's going to be a row full of double crochets, which will repeat row number 3. So chain 3, a double, counts as a double crochet into the chain 1 space, and double crochet into the double crochet. Again, double crochet into the chain 1 space, a double crochet into the double crochet. Like so, all the way till the end. Getting to the end, make sure, don't forget to put a double crochet into the chain 1 space, and the last one will go into the third chain from the beginning. And this is what we have. And turn again. This time we will repeat row number 4. Chain 3 counts as a double crochet. One double crochet into the next 2. Then chain 1, skip next double crochet, add 2 more double crochet, one in each of the next, chain 1, skip 1, again, one double crochet in each of the next 3. And when you get to the end, chain 1, skip 1, and we're gonna have just enough for 3 double crochets. 2 go into the stitches, and the last one into the third chain from the beginning. And now we'll repeat row number 5, where we are gonna put chain 3, counts as a double crochet, one double crochet into the double crochets, then a double crochet into the chain 1 space. Then again, basically in each stitch, and chain or space around all the way till the end, like so. And this is what we ended up with. So now you can see the entire row opened, then some of them picking, then open, then picking, plus alternating with full rows. I think it gives it a really nice design that is not as boring as just double crochets. And this was it for today's tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll give it a thumbs up and we'll subscribe. Also, you might want to check out these tutorials on the sides of the screen. I have some more interesting stitches if you want to learn something new. Other than that, take care. I'll see you soon. Bye!